Red. As a child, I loved red cherries, red balloons, red ketchup with hot samosas, red toys. Red was the color of my mother's bindi. Red, the cross on the doctor's car. Red mehendi, red frogs, red roses, red candy bars. Red was beauty, was love, was passion, was dreams. And then I grew up and something changed. Goodness of red escaped from a crack and it became the color of shame, of pain. I was around 11 when I saw Red River flowing between my thighs. I was frightened, confused. I had blood cancer, I thought. I didn't know that this blood would become my lifelong adversary, that red would become my nemesis. My life would now be full of don'ts. Don't walk like that. Don't talk to boys. Don't dress like that. Don't think like that. Shh! Don't speak about those things. Don't go out late. Don't go to the kitchen. Stop! Don't pray! 5 long days. Days of impurity. Living life of an untouchable. Living life like I didn't exist. 5 long days that I had to bear on my own. Uncertain, uncomfortable, ignored. 5 long days when even God wiped me off his list. Can you imagine the horror of the 11-year-old girl who suddenly discovers that she's become a woman and it's nothing beautiful. She's not beautiful. She feels tainted. She feels ashamed. And I was not the only one. There are many like me who step into puberty not knowing that their bodies are the most beautiful vessels. Vessels with the power to bring forth humanity. Surrounded by myth, burdened by taboo, they consider themselves a curse. They learn no hygiene. Rags, ashes, leaves. They use any means to remove all traces of shame. They drop out of school. They withdraw into themselves, wondering why their body limits them. Who clipped their wings? For humanity to live, they bleed. They have 1,000 questions that they are too scared to voice, too ashamed to think. But they need to be told, the children like me, that womanhood is not a witch, that puberty means life, that menstruation is not a disease. With care, understanding and knowledge, give her the strength to untangle the barbed fences, to break societal taboo. Talk to her, discuss it, tell her that she has magic within her and it's wonderful and that the red blood that comes from within her doesn't make her dirty, impure and that her red blood will one day help another heart beat.